Flat feet affects a large percentage of the population throughout the world. Flat feet occurs because the tendons holding the joints in the foot together are loose. Dr. Aaron Bean of Desert Regional Medical Center in Palm Springs explains this condition further and the treatments currently offered.
30% of adults and even kids have flat feet. The other 30% have a high arch foot, and then the rest of us have a normal type foot. But probably about 30% of us have flat feet that may or may not hurt. There is a familial component. We know that, you know, patients that come in, even kids with a symptomatic painful flat foot, I'll always ask them, does your mom or dad have a flat foot? And I'd say about 80% of the time they say, yeah, dad's got flat feet, they hurt too, and we know that, you know, it's about time to bring him in. So definitely we think there's a genetic component. So a lot of times they get pain, the foot starts to collapse and the foot rolls in, or we call pronates. So they get a lot of pain on the inside of the foot in the arch, and in a severe flat foot, sometimes they'll get pain on the outside of the foot or the ankle because the foot is actually collapsing and pinching the outside of the foot. Typically, I start seeing kids somewhere around 7, 8 years old. And a lot of times these kids, by the time they hit 4 or 5 years old, they have a flat feet, most kids do, and they grow out of it, they start to develop an arch. But about 7, 8 years old is when they start having pain in these feet, and that's when we start seeing them come in the office and evaluate them and start a treatment program. So in the early stages, especially with children, usually it's a flexible deformity. In rare cases, you get an abnormal bone bridge or a congenital deformity that needs to be surgically corrected, you know, more immediately. But in most of the cases, we start with a custom orthotic. So we take a mold of these children's feet, it's a match for their arch, and then they wear this device that'll support and lift up this flexible flat foot. And a lot of times it relaxes the tendons, takes the pressure off the foot, and in some instances can prevent having surgery down the road. So usually that's what we start with, is a more custom molded device that fits in their shoe. Flat feet and plantar fasciitis, there definitely is a connection there. We find that patients, when that arch collapses, they start to develop pain in that plantar fascia, which is a ligament on the bottom of the foot. I'd say about 50% of my patients with a symptomatic flat foot also have plantar fasciitis. So again, we usually start with a custom molded orthotic to lift up the arch and support the foot. The arch of the foot, it's not just a bony structure, there's tendons and ligaments that contribute to that. So we start with that custom orthotic, some stretching and anti-inflammatory, and most patients get some relief with that treatment. If these patients don't respond to conservative treatment, then we have a surgical protocol that we follow that's tailored for the patient. We actually do a fair amount of flat foot surgery on patients, and patients get a lot of relief. We find that with this flat foot surgery, we're preventing an arthritic foot that would have to be fused later on down the road. So in patients that are in their 40s and 50s, they're a good candidate for this reconstructive flat foot surgery that can prevent them from having arthritic problems that would be a more drastic, motion-limiting surgery down the road. We can actually restore a more normal arch and provide a foot that mechanically is more stable, so that 20, 30 years after these reconstructive flat foot surgeries, the patients have a normal functioning foot. And a lot of times we're finding that these adults that put off this flat foot surgery and just deal with the pain, they come to us when they're 70, 80 years old and have a collapsed arthritic foot that can sometimes be difficult to reconstruct at that time.